Hi everyone, it's Aunt Fernita. Today's story is called Come Help Us. Today's message is I serve God when I share my home with others. The memory verse is taken from Hebrews chapter 13, verse 2. It says, "Do not forget to entertain strangers, for some people have entertained angels without knowing it." Do you enjoy getting ready for a guest in your home? What is your special responsibility as your family prepares? Do you help fix special food? Do you help with cleaning the house? Our Bible story today is about the kindness of a good woman. Come over to Macedonia and help us. Paul woke up with a start and looked around him. He listened to the even breathing of his friends. No one else was awake. "Silas! Silas, wake up!" Paul said.
"Oh!"
Silas rolled over. "Silas, Luke, Timothy, wake up!" Paul was wide awake now. "I know where we're supposed to go next," he said excitedly to his sleepy companions. "God just gave me a vision. I saw a man from Macedonia saying, 'Come over and help us. Come over and help us.'" Silas yawned and stretched. "That's great, Paul. We can catch a ship over to Neapolis from here." Paul didn't sleep much the rest of the night. He knew God was leading them to the cities of Macedonia, and he could hardly wait to be on his way. Soon the four friends were in Philippi, a city in Macedonia. They began preaching to everyone who would listen. They enjoyed sharing their love for Jesus. When Sabbath came, Paul said, "Let's go outside the city and sit by the river for our worship." As they neared the riverside, they saw a group of women who had already gathered there to pray. "May we join you?" Paul asked politely. "Yes, please. We would like that," one of the women answered. Then she introduced herself. "I'm Lydia, and these are my friends." Paul was happy to meet these women who loved God. It didn't matter if the person was a man or a woman, Jew or Greek. He wanted to share the love of Jesus with everyone. Although Jesus had been living on earth just a short time ago, there were many people who did not know about him. As they sat down, Paul breathed a little prayer. "Holy Spirit, please open the hearts of these women to the good news of Jesus." Then Paul told the women how Jesus lived and died to save us. The new friends talked and prayed together. Then some of the women left, but Lydia stayed. "I would like to know more. I would like to know why Jesus died for me," she said. That same day, Lydia and her whole family were baptized. Lydia was so happy. "Please, Paul, won't you and your companions come stay with us?" Paul was pleased. He smiled and Lydia encouraged him. "We would love to have you," she said. So while they worked in Philippi, Paul, Silas, Luke, and Timothy stayed at Lydia's house. Lydia was a respected businesswoman in her town. She sold special purple cloth, and it seemed as if everyone knew her. Because of Lydia's kindness in sharing her home, many people learned about Jesus. Her home became the main meeting place for the new believers in that city. Lydia served God through sharing her home. Maybe you can't have a guest live at your house like Lydia did, but wherever you are, you can help others feel at home by being friendly and kind.
This podcast is read by Franita Buddy for gracelink.net. Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. Post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. Animation and artwork by Giogo Godoy. The audio engineer was Karel Holness. For more information, please visit gracelink.net.